Endometriosis is a terrible problem which can cause infertility and pelvic pain. Unfortunately, endometriosis can be very difficult to diagnose. Traditionally, endometriosis has been diagnosed by surgery, which allows a physician to see inside the abdomen. This is obviously a very invasive procedure. Are there other ways to diagnose endometriosis that can help you avoid surgery? Stay tuned. First, a very brief introduction. What is endometriosis? Endometriosis is when the tissue which normally grows inside of the uterine cavity instead grows outside of the uterus. Most commonly, endometriosis is found in the abdomen and pelvis. There are varying degrees of endometriosis, and different systems describe how much endometriosis a person has. One common classification system is provided by the American Society for Reproductive Medicine, or ASRM. The system has four categories: minimal, mild, moderate, and severe. Why is this important to you? Generally, the less extensive your endometriosis is, the harder it is to diagnose. Surgery is the gold standard. All stages of endometriosis can be diagnosed with surgery, even stage one, the lowest amount. One method for diagnosing endometriosis without surgery is by using transvaginal ultrasound. Ultrasound is only able to diagnose endometriosis if there are endometriosis cysts in the ovaries, known as endometriomas. Here is an ultrasound image of a normal ovary. The little black areas are tiny cysts called follicles. Each follicle contains an egg that is too small to be seen on ultrasound. These types of cysts are normal and do not signify endometriosis. Here is an ovary with an abnormal cyst. Notice that the inside of the cyst is clear and black. There are many things that can cause a cyst that looks like this, but this is not an endometriosis cyst. Here is an ultrasound of a classic endometrioma or endometriosis cyst. Instead of being clear black on the inside, it has a homogeneous gray appearance. The vast majority of the time, if we see a cyst like this in the ovary, it means the presence of an extensive amount of endometriosis, typically moderate to severe in the ASRM classification. Another method for diagnosing endometriosis is called magnetic resonance imaging, or MRI. Unlike ultrasound, which is routinely performed in your doctor's office, MRI is available only in hospitals or specialized imaging centers. Like ultrasound, MRI is very poor for identifying small amounts of endometriosis. It is about the same as ultrasound for identifying endometrioma cysts. MRI is not as convenient as ultrasound and is a lot more expensive, but it might be a good choice for those people whose ovaries are difficult to see clearly on ultrasound. There has been a lot of interest in recent years about the use of biomarkers. Biomarkers are molecules identified in your blood, urine, or from a biopsy that indicate whether a person has endometriosis or not. Biomarkers are exciting if they work, because it would make diagnosing endometriosis much more convenient and less invasive. One biomarker you may hear about is a blood test for a protein called CA125. Some people with endometriosis have higher levels of CA125 in their blood. Unfortunately, high CA125 levels can be seen in people with problems other than endometriosis, so it is not specific to endometriosis. In many women with endometriosis, their levels of CA125 are normal, so it is not a very sensitive test either. In order for a biomarker to be valuable, you would like it to identify most, if not all, people with endometriosis and not be fooled by other problems. In other words, you would like a test to be sensitive and specific. In the last 25 years, many different molecules have been offered as possible biomarkers for endometriosis, but so far, none of them have any convincing data that they are both sensitive and specific for endometriosis. If we can't find a single biomarker that will reliably diagnose endometriosis, what if we were to combine several biomarkers, or 100, or 1,000? Might this improve the accuracy? There is promising evidence that it might. Interpreting the results of many different biomarkers together is complicated, but using computers to look for patterns can help. I'll give you one example. In 2023, scientists from China looked at the activity of 9 different genes. The activity of each of these genes has, in the past, shown some relationship with endometriosis, but none by themselves were very accurate. Using a computer algorithm to combine the results of the individual markers, they found that the entire panel was much more sensitive and specific for endometriosis than each individual test was alone. As a result of studies like this, I predict that in the next year or two, we will have a very reliable blood test to diagnose endometriosis. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.